Hi, I'm Steve Jones and I'm going to tell you a little bit about how the sun works. First of all, we have to say, what is the sun? Well, we know the sun is a star. It is not a particularly big star and not a small star. It's a kind of medium-sized star. And a star is a ball of burning gas. It is kept as it is by nuclear reactions, but not the kind of nuclear reactions we think of in a nuclear reactor on Earth. Those are called fission reactions. It's by thermonuclear reactions, which are fusion reactions. So we call them fusion reactions. And the process of fusion, unlike fission, the process of fusion is about chemicals coming together to build bigger chemicals. So, for example, the smallest atom is hydrogen. So within the sun, hydrogen is reacting with other hydrogen to create helium. You need a very, very high temperature to get this reaction to occur, something over 10 million degrees Celsius, or 10 million Celsius. This is a hugely high temperature. It's the kind of temperature you get in the middle of an atomic bomb. So these high temperatures produce a ball of gas where the surface temperature, just the temperature on the surface, ranges between about 4,000 and 6,000 Celsius. Of course, we know there are hot spots on the surface, and it's these hot spots which produce interference on radio communications. So you have to watch for sunspots and you will get interference on your radio. So this is basically how the sun works. At any one time, in any one second, the sun is burning 4 million tons of material. Gives you an idea of how very big the sun is and how very powerful. We are 8 minutes as light travels from the sun, and yet, imagine the amount of energy we get from there. Think about the amount of energy in the sun itself. So that's a little bit about how the sun works.